I utilized a couple of different things. This is a Chopart's amputation, and diabetic, dialysis, smoker, right? Kind of the repertoire that we are seeing on a regular basis. Dialysis patients are becoming more and more frequent as diabetes goes up, and diabetes affects every system in the body from head to toe. And it's the number one risk for development of people going on dialysis, the number one risk for that, as it is the number one risk for the retinopathy, is the number one risk for blindness in the developed world, obviously. Heart attack and stroke is the number one cause for those. Diabetes affects every system in your body through the oxidative stress that occurs, and including into the wound healing cascade. So he ended up with a Chopart's amputation, and you're starting to look, you see the bottom of his calcaneus there and tissue that is exposed. And he had a lot of bleeding. He was revascularized, obviously, on his anticoagulation. I didn't want to stop it. I didn't use a tourniquet for this. But afterwards of putting the Omni-stat on, it's one of my, I do, once the bleeding is done, then we put a wound VAC over the top of that, okay, to help to encourage all the good things that a wound VAC does. But it's an instance when, and all these pictures that I've shown you are areas where people that have significant bleeding because they're anticoagulated, we have the capability now to be able to put something on that works independently of that clotting cascade, doesn't harm the tissue, relatively quick time to getting hemostasis, and then being able to support other therapies that we are using and utilizing to help these patients with significant morbidity and mortality.